Hi, today I'm explaining about movie clip symbols in Animate CC. Okay, yesterday we already learned these graphic symbols. Okay, in symbols, actually we have graphic symbols, animate symbols, movie clip symbols and button symbols are there. The first graphic symbols already we observed, then we are using movie clip symbols. So what are them? Okay, suppose you can delete this. You can delete this. These two layers. Deleting. Okay. The second one is movie clip symbols. This is can unlock and keep this, and you can create one more layer here. Now I'm creating one shape here. Okay, this is my drawing. Now what I'll do, right click on that and convert to symbol. Okay, there you give name, any name. Now instead of graphic symbol, press and movie clip. Okay, so save. Okay, this is my movie clip. Okay, you can check the library. From library, see there are symbols. This is a normal symbol. Okay, we use this first one. See the difference between two icons. For graphic symbol, the icon is showing this. For the movie clip symbol, showing this. Okay, so this is, you can rename this, otherwise graphic, and this is a movie clip. Movie clip, that's it. Now select the movie clip and drag, so as many as you want. Okay, so these are all the movie clip, and the showing here, the center point is registration point. Okay, so these are the instances of the movie clip. So that means what, instead of copying pasting to get the multiple the images, multiple objects on stage. Okay, instead of copying and pasting, we convert that one the image into symbol, that too in movie clip symbol. Okay, from library we drag this movie clip symbol on stage. Okay, now you can click anywhere here. You can click anywhere here and double click. You reach inside a symbol editing mode. The symbol editing mode means what you do that very first. That is okay. So this is your actual shape. Okay, so by double clicking on that, come back from movie clip symbol, and if you want to go inside again, you can click anywhere on the instance and double click on that. You reach inside that. Okay, there you draw modification. You give one modification. Okay, it is applying to all instances. See, these are the instances of that movie clip. See them? Yes. Now individually you can reduce the size. Suppose here you can reduce size can change the place also. And here you can add the brightness. Suppose this is the full brightness, means that black, and from here to this is tint actually. So tint means if you add the white in any color, you will get the tint of that color. Tint means almost the bright. Okay, so slowly you are adding color, and this is actual color, and you are going to be shatter into shade. Okay, so value you can choose which value you want, and you can choose this there. Again click on this tint, and here the values are there, the tint value you are giving. Now it is getting into the blue, dark blue, and I'm adding the redness. When you add the redness, it is coming into purple, and slowly red purple, and it is pinkish. Okay, so how you want, you can decide. And now come here, and then on the tintness, and suppose move back these, and suppose increase the green or decrease this green, the blueness here, yeah? Change this blueness. Yes, now it is into some dark blue. Okay, yes, and now click this and come here and click on the advanced. In advanced we have plus and minuses. Here you can the percentage of alphaness. Alphaness is means what? The transparency. Suppose here the minus it is in, so there is no image showing there. Now see, you are getting into a darker object. Okay, make it 100%, and here you can give the alphaness minus. Then here come the redness. Suppose here decrease this red, increase the decrease the red, and here the zero value you can increase or decrease. See, it is changing into. Okay, and suppose here the green also you can decrease. Now it is almost black. You can add this by checking all these things. You will understand all this. Yes, now it is coming into blue. Perfect. Yes, this is blue. Okay, now click here, get into advanced again. Okay, so make it green dull and blue also dull. You can add this, or otherwise red you can add. Yes, now see this almost like orange. Okay, and here click here, and again come here alpha. In alpha level you can reduce the opacity of the object. Yes, this is okay. And now because of this, it is converted into a movie clip. Okay, so here you will get the filters here. The filters means what? Effects, these are. So you can create the drop shadow. Okay, so add the drop shadow. You can see this is adding, and here we have the strength values also there. You can give the strengths, and the low, medium and high also there, and angle, change the angle also how you want. Okay, and suppose this is a knockout in opposite, okay, and here it is inner shadow. You'll get inside shadow, and here it is hide object. Simply you can hide object, only the effects can show. Okay, and change the color also, which color actually you want, that you can decide. Okay, and the same way here we have others also, their glow, so you can give the glowness. So choose this glow. Yes, and it is high. The strength is decrease. Okay. So these are knockouts and inner glow. Okay, and now here you can check other, suppose bevel is there. Okay, the bevelness is adding the value. If you observe here, it is adding that. Suppose it is highlight, the distance also you can change. Okay, and suppose it is knockout. Yes, and click here, you can observe other effects, the gradient glow and the gradient bevel. So you can apply the gradient bevel. So from suppose blue to some yellow. Okay, and suppose knockout, you can make it high. So these are the effects. When you convert your object into movie clip symbol, then only the effects can display here. In the old versions, this is the method. For the coming new versions, what, even for the graphic symbols also, when you convert your object into graphic symbol, so automatically the filters can display even for graphic symbols also. But for the old versions, for movie clip symbols only, the filters can display here. Okay. Yes. Now, what is the difference between graphic symbol and movie clip symbol? Of course, the filters can display. Okay, but what is that? Suppose I'll explain. The graphic symbols are individual, that static images. Okay, the individual frames there, they represent individual frames, static images. But here you can insert your whole animation into movie clip. It can be a one frame, within one frame your entire animation will be there. Okay, so I'll explain you about that. You can draw this shape. Okay, and suppose you can convert this to first graphic symbol. Okay, I'm explaining you between difference between graphic and movie clip symbol. Okay, and now at frame 40, right click and insert keyframe. Okay, the same keyframe, I'll explain at animation time what is keyframe and frame and blank keyframe. I'll explain, don't worry, but just to explain difference between graphic and movie clip symbol, simply I'm doing small animation, so no need to worry. I'll explain all about keyframes and all. Right, I place it here at one first frame, one drawing, and at 40th another drawing. Okay, but the two drawings are at the same place. Okay, but I want this second frame, want this in different place. So now you can check this, the first frame is here and that 40 frame, this is there. Okay, switch on the onion skin. Now we'll understand, because there are the frame markers are there. So this the frame markers, these are showing you, these are the markers are showing you when you click on onion skin. Now between these two, between these two keyframes, this is one and this is two, between these two keyframe, anywhere on timeline, right click and create classic twin. Okay, this is your classic twin. So switch on this onion skin, you will understand. It is the system, the software itself, it is creating the motion, generating motion. Okay, so this is your animation. Okay, here the instant player is there, just you can click on that, your animation is moving. Just click on that, your animation is moving. Or otherwise control enter to see your animation preview. Okay, control enter. Because these are the blinking, to avoid that blinkingness, I use guides. So if we use guides, it won't come in final animation. Now again control enter. Yeah, now see your animation is moving from left to right. This is simple animation with a graphic convert into graphic symbol. Okay, now what I am doing, suppose you can select all frames. That means these are all, these are, okay, and right click and cut frames, and here insert a new symbol and make it in graphic. Okay, and you can paste here, paste frames, paste frames. So this is your entire animation. Okay, it is in simulating mode. Now click on this arrow mark. Okay, and now click there, and from library you get your animation. Suppose this is your animation, you drag here. Now play on timeline, it is moving, and with control enter also it is showing. But because it is in timeline also, on timeline also it is showing. Suppose you can double click your animation, at already used the animation on timeline 40 frames, at 40 frames, but here also it is showing 40 frames. But if you select here and remove frames, only one frame also there, only one frame, you can control enter, won't show your animation. Even it is there at 40 frames, see it is showing in 40 frames, but your clip, your graphic clip, is the graphic symbol not extended up to 40 frames, because your animation is up to 40 frames, then only it is showing in graphic symbol. But when you delete all the 39 frames and only you are keeping your animation at first frame only, then you can play, you cannot see the animation. Control enter also, you cannot see that animation. So it is acting as a individual. So graphic symbol can act as a individual static images. Okay, that is graphic symbol. Now I'm explaining, I'm giving example for a movie clip. Okay, so the same way here, I'll take one shape here. Now you can convert this into a movie clip. Okay, say okay. At the same 45 frames, you can insert keyframe, and this frame you can keep that side, opposite side, and between these two frames, right click and create classic twin. So you created the classic twin, same like graphic. Now what you do, you can select these whole frames and right click and suppose cut and insert a new symbol, place movie clip instead of graphic symbol here, movie clip, and symbol name is 4, save OK. And now you can paste frames. Okay, now your animation is there. This is like your graphic symbol only, up to here it is same like graphic symbol only. Okay, then click on this arrow mark. Okay, and from library you can drag your movie clip animation onto stage. Okay, and now control enter. It is showing as usually same like graphic symbol, because it is also extended to 40 frames, because your animation is there up to 40 frames. At the same way, it is extended to 40 frames. It is showing the entire animation by pressing control enter. You are seeing that, but you can click here and the timeline, see, your animation is not visible. If you convert your entire animation into movie clip, on timeline you cannot see your animation. But how you see? By pressing control enter only you can see your animation. But one more thing, even suppose I select all the frames except one frame, you can remove these, because your animation is extended up to 40 frames. But here I removed all the frames, only one frame is there. You can control enter, still you can see your animation. That is the main difference between a graphic symbol and movie clip symbol. So this is a clip, your entire animation, all your frames you can insert into clip. Okay, but even not extended all the frames, even one frame if you maintain on the timeline, you can observe your animation by pressing control enter. Okay, this is not static, your clip, it is a clip, your entire animation it is there in this clip. But in graphic symbol this can be a static. Okay, when you give the whole frames, extend to whole frames, then only you can observe your animation and graphics. So this is your movie clip. It is showing even it is there in one clip. Okay, so that is the main difference between your graphic symbol and movie clip symbol. Okay, so you also have to practice this, try yourself, and if you have any doubt you can ask me. Okay, thank you.